Hello, everybody. It's Robbie. How's everybody doing today? So, today I'm going to start my Let's Play of The Inpatient. It's a game by Supermassive Games. It's something of a prequel to Until Dawn. It takes place 60 years before, though. It's all but the asylum. What is it called? Blackwood Asylum? It's the asylum where they kept all those miners who eventually turned into Wendigo. But I digress with that. I've been looking forward to playing this for quite a while now. I had pre-ordered. I would have recorded it last night, but the hell? What if I thought? Okay. I couldn't download it. There were some issues with the internet. But regardless, we have it now, and time to have some fun with this. I heard apparently there's a lot of stuff they made special for this. Like, for example, unlike some other VR games, I'm actually gonna have a full frickin' body. That's be decent. Alright, so let's just get into this. Starting new game. Not sure what to expect here. Choose your gender. This is a good question. Do I want to play as a guy or a lady? Play as male, I guess. Select your skin tone. I mean, I'm already male. I'm pretty male. I mean, pretty pale, motherfucker. So, I'm gonna say that one. Objective, you know, voice control. Speak out loud, make your selection. Yes, please. I can speak for myself. Enable or disable voice control at any time via the settings menu. For voice controls to work best, ensure there is as little background noise as possible and simply speak the lines aloud normally. Okay. Oh. Hey, Doc. He's like, take it, you're my doctor. Hello.
Let's test your memory. Do you remember who I am?
Are you a doctor?
I am worried that you are holding back. Try speaking with some emotion.
Where am I?
This is the Blackwood Sanatorium. Do you know why you're here?
I was afraid it got me. We locked up eventually. No, I don't know.
You need to speak up, or I won't be able to help you. Nothing ventured, nothing gained.
No, I don't know. No, I don't know.
You're having trouble with your memory. We're trying to help you.
I've been having that for years.
Close your eyes. Take a deep breath.
Okay.
Let the walls fall away. Try to visualize the last thing you can remember before you came here.
Okay. The hell? Who the hell are you? This guy vaguely reminds me of Dr. A.J. Hill from Until Dawn.
So, did you remember anything?
Do a flashlight. Yes, I remembered something.
Describe it to me.
Crazy bastard with a flashlight came after me. I was hiding.
Ah, interesting. Doctor, we seem to be making some progress.
Is there anything else? Voice thing,
any small details. Nothing is too insignificant.
I saw a man with no face.
I'm gonna try this again. So, please, relax, take a deep breath.
Wait, did I?
Think about that.
Fuck, I actually do have memory issues. Jesus.
No matter how much it may scare or upset you, it's important you face the hard truth.
A second. I'm just gonna change something here.
Now, what can you recall?
I remember the same thing. The memory was shorter. Yeah, it was shorter.
Perhaps we've been pushing you too hard.
Remember the same thing, but it was shorter. The guy didn't come in this time.
I know this hasn't been easy, but I'd really like to try once more. Do you think you have it in you?
Well. Okay. Let's take a shot at her.
Okay. Relax. Concentrate. Let the memory come in.
June 14th, Monday.
So far it appears to be completely successful.
What appears to be successful? The memory seems to be getting shorter every time.
Now, what can you tell me? Please.
Yeah, it's not helping.
Understand me. I would never do anything to harm a patient.
I don't believe you.
Now, you look like you could benefit from some rest. One final thing, and it's the key to the success of this treatment. You do understand I want what's best for you.
Sure you do. I don't trust guys with bow ties. For the time being, I don't have any reason to not believe him, so yeah, I believe you.
Good. You should know that we have made remarkable progress today.
Okay.
You must learn to walk before you can crawl.
Wait, what? I think you got that in reverse, buddy. You have to learn to crawl before you can walk.
Time now to rest and heal. Let the memories come home to roost. This'll help. I'll have an orderly take you to your room. Let's talk outside.
I don't trust this guy. Seems shifty. Greg and Abe. So we already know who two of the characters are. Abe, you look... You know what? Fuck it, yeah. I never felt better.
Yep. Good, good. Time to put you back on the shelf.
You look like the kind of guy I'm gonna like.
Bragg will take his toys apart just to see if he can put them back together again. Hope he's not losing his touch.
I'm hoping that too. The butterfly effects. Oh, my theater. A tiny butterfly flapping its wings today may lead to a devastating hurricane weeks from now. So it's the same intro to Until Dawn. I take it this is going to be like reoccurring throughout the series if they make more of them. Small session can drag the chain of events. Huh.
Hello, Suzanne.
Suzanne, hi. Hey, how you doing? Your face. I guess you like her, don't you?
Well, shoot. Guess I ain't fit to shine her shoes. You think a girl like that would ever give me the time of day? Look who's talking, big guy. At least I ain't wearing prophylactic pajamas.
Oh, I didn't really see that there was another option. It was off to the side of my head. I didn't... Yeah, fuck. Pharmacy treatment rooms. Okay, we're heading off to the pharmacy. Get my pills! Oh, jeez. This looks gorgeous, though. Back in the theater. Your actions will shape how the story unfolds.
Let me just call us a cab.
All right. Who am I?
You're just another patient. An endless stream of patients for old Abe to push around.
Where are we going? Where are we going? I don't want to know.
Back to the presidential suite. Wouldn't want to be late for your spa treatment.
I like you already. You know that?
Yeesh. You think Braggett's spring for an upgrade? The staff's sake, at least. Whole place going to pieces.
You see it in on the lawn. It was a crap. And again, a bunch of Wendigos took a bat to the place, if I understand.
Let's not strain ourselves, eh? Coming down the home stretch.
All right.
Duty calls.
All right, go get him. Can you at least like undo my wrist straps? Come on.
Just a nightmare. You know there are real.
It's real.
It's real. Yeah. So please calm down.
No, I will not calm down.
Or I'll you are the worst it will be.
Man, she's got the touch. Smart cookie over there.
Victoria, huh? Okay, we're getting to know some of the nurses and
that's enough fun of you.
Some of the staff around here. Story is one of many possibilities. Choose your actions carefully. Alright. I'll do that, just like I did with Until Dawn.
You're back. Just a little blackout, no big deal. All just part of the treatment. Almost back to your private little oasis.
Great. Can I walk around?
You're hey. Okay. Look at me. Everything is going to be okay.
I believe you.
Let's get you ready for that.
Probably shouldn't.
All right.
But
lights out.
She's even nice. Hello, everybody. It's Robbie. How's everybody doing today? So, today I'm going to start my Let's Play of The Inpatient. It's a game by Supermassive Games. It's something of a prequel to Until Dawn. Takes place 60 years before, though. It's all but the asylum. What is it called? Blackwood Asylum? It's the asylum where they kept all those miners who eventually turned into Wendigo. But I digress with that. I've been looking forward to playing this for quite a while now. I had pre-ordered. I would have recorded it last night, but... the hell? What if I... Okay. But I couldn't. Couldn't download it. There were some issues with the internet. But regardless, we have it now, and time to have some fun with this. I heard apparently there's a lot of stuff they made special for this. Like, for example, unlike some other VR games, I'm actually going to have a full frickin' body. That must be decent. Alright, let's just get into this. Starting new game. Not sure what to expect here. Choose your gender. This is a good question. Do I want to play as a guy or a lady? Play as male, I guess. Select your skin tone. I mean, I'm already male. I'm pretty male. I mean, pretty pale, motherfucker. So, I'm gonna say that one. Objectional voice control. Speak out loud, make your selection. Yes, please. I can speak for myself. Enable or disable voice control at any time via the settings menu. For voice controls to work best, ensure there is a little background noise as possible and simply speak the lines aloud normally. Okay. Oh. Hey, Doc. He's like, take it, you're my doctor. Hello.
Let's test your memory.
Abe and Suzanne. Date. Trip. Oh, he's... Was he going through a list of things he wanted to do? Takes Suzanne on the date? Took movies. Saturday night. Dancing? Does she like dancing? Walk together in the woods. Play to eat. Keep it casual. What the f- What? Hey, what's up? Just remember her crying, okay. So this here, still on treatment today, complained of noises during the night, overcoming patient visits. What? Okay, what's the spark say? Okay, hold it. Sit on the bed.
Hey, did you find a piece of paper with my notes scribbled on it?
You mean that thing?
Did you read my notes?
No, I wouldn't do that. Yeah, I'm gonna be serious. You're quite the poet.
You really shouldn't have. I guess you were just killing time, but curiosity killed the cat.
And satisfaction resurrected it. That's the full saying, buddy.
Let's get you ready for bed. Lights out soon.
Okay. Pretty spacious room, I guess, that much.
Lights out.
I mean, every other asylum I've seen in the game is usually like basically living in a closet. Okay, Jesus.
Nabureon Don Kabu Ashinowega Gontiki. Nabureon.
Hey, bud. Just follow me. Come along.
Okay. Okay, that was kind of more of a Rusty Lake vibe right there, the antler man. So he said to follow him. That was a weirder stream.
Morning. Rise and shine.
And who is this guy? I didn't see you before.
Good morning to you.
Good morning. I'll be friendly to her. Good morning. Good to see you.
You should know we are very encouraged. You're on the road to a complete recovery.
You can't treat me like this! I'm gonna get you out of here!
Yeah, crazy my best over there.
Always going to be patients that are beyond our help. But I know that you only want to get better. Maybe you should meet your new roommate.
Oh, new roommate. That's why I didn't see you before. How's it going there, bud? I'm Robbie. How you doing? Hi.
Okay, well, if we're stuck in here together, we might as well get to know each other.
Yeah.
What brings you to this fine establishment?
So you're Gordon, okay. Amnesia, apparently. Can't remember shit.
That's what they got me in here for, too. Crazy thing is, I don't have amnesia. Everything is clear as a bell. Doesn't stop them from messing with my noggin. So, these treatments, they ever get any easier?
Some barbaric. I hope so.
Hope you're on the level. Name's Gordon. You?
Robbie.
Figures. Half the people in here don't know themselves from Adam. I guess the pain don't let up.
Oh, wait, we got something here?
Shut eye. Talk later.
Yeah, okay, we'll do that.
How we'll spend it. They always said you can do things on a leap day you can't on any other. Like, a woman proposing to a man. Is that crazy?
No. Not crazy at all. Holy shit. Okay. Just kind of jolted me over here. Okay, I'm gonna open my desk here. Controls are a little odd. Well, that's interesting. I got a sandwich. Is this lime and rye? If it is, I'll eat it. Fuck. Oh, wait, I can actually eat it. Even though I hit my PSVR. Here. I guess I can't eat all of it. Yeah, I can't eat all of it, I guess. Just took a bite out of it. Hey, Gordon.
Hey, buddy. You all right? You were shaking the sheets a little last night. Look, about before, I don't want you to get the wrong idea about me. I don't know what they're doing to me, but it's just I haven't been myself. I think it's...
Oh, somebody coming? Oh, the nurse is back.
Hello, gentlemen.
Victoria, that's right. Forgot her name for a second.
Did I make parole?
I was kind of wondering, Victoria and her are two different people, but hey.
Personally, for now, I get comfortable.
God damn it, Victoria. What do you make of her? You think she's on the level?
I like her.
Yeah. She's a little drunk on her own power, if you ask me.
I see someone was hungry. Very, very good.
Him, I was up for a sandwich. So.
Believe that? Fucking tell me what to do? Good thing they saved all the cigarette butts and bottle caps for this gruel. Ugh. How can anyone eat this? I don't know how many more of these I can take. So give it up. You want out of here. Screw this voluntary nonsense, right?
Yeah.
I'm shocked. You'd give up this five-star cuisine? You're a fighter, I can tell. You'll get it all back. Now, I think I need to put all my energy into shoving this toxic waste down my throat.
All right. You do that, buddy.
You here just a little bit longer.
You tell Bragg that I'm done. I voluntarily choose to leave.
Fine. I okay. I'll let him know.
Let me guess. Gordon's just gonna disappear, isn't he?
Can't trust anyone in this damn snake pit. Right? You don't trust a word they say either, do you?
I Maybe. I mean, I like Victoria and Abe.
What they can do with their damn treatments.
Oh, we got a runner. Damn it. Thing keeps confusing a perfect turnaround with
Mr. Sandman, come over here.
Okay.
Another patient on the loose. Cue the three-ring circus. Not like it doesn't happen once a week around here. They'll have them doped and drooling in no time.
Where's the option two? It sounds worse than that. That happened to us.
Look, you and I, we're not like the rest of the folks in here. You get that, right?
But we are patients. What do you mean?
We have trouble with our memories. It'd be a lot worse from what I've seen around here. They should just take...
Yeah, that does sound like something that dream.
Yeah, that makes two of us. I need a minute. Let me just think about this.
Okay. You think. I'm just gonna go, look over here.
All right, that's
oh, jeez.
Lights out.
Oh. Hey, it's Gordon.
Right this way.
Gordon? You had a little pain in the neck there.